How's it going, guys and girls? Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Online. My name is Camel, and today I'm going to walk you through how to find racial crafting motifs. For those of you who don't know, when you use this, you permanently learn how to craft items in the corresponding race's style. Now, a motif looks like this. So if you see any of these in-game, make sure to grab that sucker like your girlfriend's. Moving on! Now, I'm going to show and explain to you how to actually find these motifs. I'll show you some footage of me finding these motifs. I'll show you how to use a motif so your character permanently learns how to craft items in the corresponding race's style. And of course, me crafting some items in the race's styles that I learned from the racial motifs that you will see me pick up in this video. So this video is for those of you who are stuck on how the styling works within crafting, and also for those of you who want to collect all 14 motifs. Okay, now you will find racial crafting motifs in cities. More specifically, you will find them in storage units found within buildings inside a city. About 95% of these storage units are found in bedchambers, so your best bet is to go anywhere where there's a bed. You can also find them in basements and some other weird places, so always have a look around. So what you want to look for, you want to go into a city or any town, head to a house or a great hall, an inn, anything like that. Head upstairs, downstairs, sideways, anywhere where there's a bed. Now I'll show you what you're actually looking for. These five legendarily mythical storage units that you want to look for are nightstands, which look like this. Dressers, which look like this. Cupboards, which look like this. Desks, which look like this. And lastly, trunks, which look like this. These five storage units all share the same loot roll, and you have a chance of getting any loot that you can get from one from the others. Please keep in mind that the skins for these storage units will change between factions. They will still have exactly the same names, they will just look slightly different. And at the end of the day, a cupboard is still a cupboard, and you'll know exactly what you're looking for. So, now that you actually know what you're aiming for, let's talk about how to actually find us some racial motifs and make all of our friends jealous. Your best chances of finding unlooted storage units is to go to a city or a town that is a bit out of the way and underpopulated with players. Once it's been looted, it takes about 10 to 20 minutes to respawn with loot. So once you've looted them, run out of the house, use the Way Shrine, go to the next city, pillage all the loot out of all the people's bedrooms, and then head over to the next city. So as you'll see me here running around, going into inns and houses and big great halls, running up and downstairs, checking out the bedrooms, the night tables. You'll find all kinds of loot in these things, like lockpicks, styling ores, provisioning recipes, and other great items like this. So, as your viewers have probably noticed, I've gone into this big great hall here. Now I'm going to run up the stairs and check out the bedchambers upstairs. Some of these storage units have been looted, like that nightstand there. This trunk's free though. Grab that. Oh, that trunk's been taken. That other nightstand's been taken. No problem. Just move on to the other side and hopefully find some. There it is, racial motif! God, that's satisfying. Now, I didn't look at that item for long, but I wasn't going to risk anything happening on that thing in my inventory, which is where we'll head now to take a look at that beautiful, beautiful item. And there it is. Good work, guys. We have acquired our first racial motif. And look at that, racial motif number one for our first motif, the High Elves. Now, I'm going to see if I can find one more. And then we're going to head back to a crafting station, and I'll show you what it looks like to craft in other races' styles. And here we go, after some searching, we have successfully come across our second racial motif, number 5, the Bretons. Alright, let's head back to a crafting station and craft some items with these racial styles applied. Now, before we can craft items with styles corresponding to these motifs that we found, we have to use the motifs. So here we go, just right-click on it and click Use. It'll bring up a little book with some information on that particular race's racial styling. Nothing else happens to indicate that you've learned a new style, but when you go to a crafting station, which you'll do right now, as you'll see down in the third slot there, I can now craft items with a Breton style. I can still craft items with the Nord style, because I'm a Nord. And down the end, you can see that I can also craft items with the High Elf style applied. So now that you've learnt those racial motifs, you can craft items with those racial styles applied. The only other thing you need that some people get stuck on when it comes to styling is the styling ore. If you haven't learned about styling ores yet, I'll put a link at the end of the video for you. As we can see here, the Breton styling ore is molybdenum, which I have 11 of there. Now I'm going to craft myself a whole set of iron heavy armor with the Breton style applied. While I'm tinkering away in the background there, I'm going to talk to you about the 14 different crafting motifs that you can find and the 14 different crafting styles that these will teach you. Every motif has a different number, as we saw before with the High Elf being number 1 and the Bretons being number 5. The list is as follows. Number 1, the High Elves, otherwise known as Ultima. Number 2, the Dark Elves, otherwise known as Dunmer. Number 3, the Wood Elves, otherwise known as Bosmer. Number 4, the Nords. Number 5, the Bretons. Number 6, the Redguards. Number 7, the Khajiit. Number 8, the Orcs, otherwise known as Orisma. Number 9, the Argonians. Number 10, Imperial Sirods, otherwise known as the Imperials. Number 11, Ancient Elves. Number 12, Barbaric. Number 13, Primal. And number 14, Daedric. Every player, every race, can find and learn all 14, because that list was the list of the motifs, not just the styles, but the motifs. So there are 14 motifs corresponding to those 14 styles that I just listed. When you've learnt one, you've learnt that across all crafting. Here I'm using blacksmithing as an example, but it will work for woodworking, tailoring, and tanning as well. And there we have it, guys. Congratulations. We have successfully found racial motifs, used those racial motifs to learn how to craft in those racial styles, and crafted ourselves a whole set of armor and a weapon in the Breton crafting style. There we go. Let's take a look at this. Is there anything better than crafting yourself a whole set of armor and a weapon? Now, I'll just let you guys know that these racial motifs are completely tradable between players, so if you find two of the same racial motif, do not be discouraged. You can sell that to another player or trade it to another player for a different racial motif that you don't have. Okay, guys and girls, that's it for this video on how to find racial crafting motifs. I hope this video has helped you guys out, I hope you've learnt something, and I hope that you find all the racial crafting motifs that you are looking for. If you wish to learn anything else about the Elder Scrolls Online crafting, I'll put a link up to my playlist, the Elder Scrolls Online crafting tutorials and guides, at the end of the video, and I will have videos on just about everything in there. Also, if you would like to have a look at the 10 playable races, armor styles, for light armor, medium armor, and heavy armor, at the end of the video, I'll also put a link up to my racial armor styles and skill tree playlist, where you can find a video on each of the 10 playable races. If you can't find what you're looking for, if you have any questions, or if you have any information to add that could help myself or any other players, please leave a comment below. If you found this video helpful or entertaining, please leave a like. Share this video to all of your friends, all of your guildmates, and anyone else you find who is struggling to learn about the racial motifs. And if you enjoyed this video and would like me to keep making videos like this one, please subscribe. Alright, Camel Pods. Don't forget to click the links above on the screen there. Thank you very much for watching, and
I'll see you later in the next video.